Hello students, today we are going to study about one of the important physiology of human, that is human digestive system. Now you all know to do any work, our body need energy. From where our body is getting this energy? It is getting from food. But is the food, whatever you are consuming, is giving you directly energy in the form which you are consuming? No. The food need to be broken down, and after getting broken down, then only it can give you energy by some other process. So today we will study that how is this food broken down. It is broken down by a system called as digestive system. Now before we study what is digestive system, we need to know what is the difference between nutrients and nutrition. Now, what is nutrients, or what are nutrients? Speaking about nutrients, nutrients are those chemicals or a set of chemicals which is required by your body in proper proportion. Now, what are those chemicals which are required by your body? That is carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals along with water. So, total 6 nutrients your body need. Now, what is nutrition? Nutrition is the process of obtaining nutrient. Again, I am repeating, nutrients are the chemical required by our body, and nutrition is the mode or process of obtaining nutrients for our body. Now we'll study nutrients later, but let's study what are the mode of nutrition, or what are the way by which organism can obtain their food. So ways of nutrition or modes of nutrition. There are 2 major modes of nutrition, that is autotrophic and heterotrophic. What is autotrophic? Preparing their own food is called as autotrophic. Heterotrophic, obtaining food from other organism, is called as heterotrophic. Now, which process is carried out in autotrophic? In autotrophic, there are 2 processes. One which can be carried out in presence of light, and another which can be carried out in presence of specific chemical. Now the one which is carried out in presence of light, it is called as photosynthesis. And the one which can be carried out in presence of specific chemicals are called as chemosynthesis. Now speaking about heterotrophic organism, heterotrophic organism can obtain their food by 4 means. That is parasitic, saprophytic, holozoic and symbiosis. Now what is parasitic? Parasitic means the organism which obtain food from the body of another organism by causing them harm. The body from which they obtain food by harming them is called as host body. So 2 things you have to remember in parasitic mode. First, the body from which the organism will obtain food is called as host body, and second, the condition for obtaining food is to harm the host body. So host body and harming. Next we have saprophytic. Saprophytic means external digestion. The enzymes will be released outside the body. The food will be digested outside and the nutrient will be absorbed by the whole body. Example, bacteria and fungi. Now, holozoic means ingesting the whole food material. It is carried out in human being. And the last one is symbiosis. Two organisms will come together, have some mutual understanding. One will provide something and the another one will provide something. And in that case, both are getting some benefit. That is called as symbiosis. The best example of symbiosis is lichens. Lichens are the association of algae and fungi, which you studied in the first chapter of your syllabus. Now here we have completed the difference between nutrition and nutrients. Thank you very much, students.